It's so hard to speak after Douglas Alexander. He did not leave anything for me to say. But let me first start by acknowledging the diligent work and the commitment of the Labour Friends of Palestine, spearheaded by Simon, who are doing a great job in trying to create awareness about the Palestinian plight that has been suffering for almost 43 years now. Let me also thank the Labour Party for its bold stand in supporting the Palestinian state. And Mr. Alexander has written a beautiful letter which was conveyed to my president, to Mr. Alexander Haig, William Haig, telling him that this is about time that the Palestinians should have their own independence. Ladies and gentlemen, on Friday we marked history. We are no more the object of history, now we are the subject of history. And from now on, we are entitled for self-determination, like any other free nation. It's a long overdue catharsis. We need to be recognized by the international community, because the international community owes it to us. And self-determination is something that we have been struggling for the last 43 years. Enough of injustice, enough persecution. Ladies and gentlemen, we never said that we're going to the United Nations in lieu of negotiations. We're extending our hands to our Israeli partners, and we tell them, be credible, be bold enough, come forward, stop the settlements, and let's have an agreement once and for all. As my president said in his speech, enough is enough. Expansionism, colonial settler movement does not work. We cannot be rendered Red Indians. We cannot live in Bantustans. We are a free people. We need to have our freedom and independence. And the irony of history is the fact that today the United States, that has been supporting the Arab Spring and calling for the Arabs to have their freedom and independence, it's the same administration with the same president, now is blocking the freedom of the Palestinians by threatening and using the veto in the Security Council. It is the same United States that was the first country to recognize Israel, is the first country to use the veto against the Palestinian statehood. We have learned from the forefathers of the Americans. They have taught us about global democracy, freedom, and humanity. But what we see on the ground today is something completely the opposite. They're flexing muscles, they're threatening us by cutting aid, and they want us always to concede to the other side. Ladies and gentlemen, the United States for the last 20 years has not been a broker peace, has not been a third party that wanted to settle once and for all this conflict. It's becoming a protracted conflict, unfortunately, and what we have witnessed, it's a crisis management and not conflict resolution. We ask the international community and the European Union, spearheaded by the United Kingdom, to show their political teeth in the political process and not to be bystanders by just giving us money, because, ladies and gentlemen, we don't need charity, we need our freedom and independence. That's what we need. By conveying a message from this important podium to President Barack Obama, the Palestinian state is not for sale because it is priceless, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much.